Welcome back to my Synthesizer Basics series. If you haven't seen part one, I highly recommend doing so before continuing to watch this video, as there is a specific list of features which the whole series is covering. We have finished these first three, and we are moving on to filter. Filters, like oscillators from the previous part, are just as they sound. Filters will filter out certain areas of sound across what is called a frequency spectrum. Recall from the previous video that we saw examples of different waveforms which are produced by oscillators on board synths. Looking at these graphs and trimming them down, what remains is what we can call one full cycle of these waveforms across the dimension of time. And very, very many cycles can happen in a short period of time to produce the phenomenon that we call the pitch of a sound. Low-sounding pitches will have a low number of cycles in a given span of time, while high-sounding pitches will have a high number of cycles in the same given span of time. This is what we call the frequency of a waveform. In orchestral music, instrumentalists at the beginning before performances will always tune their instruments to what is known as A440, with A being the musical letter to name the pitch, and the 440 meaning 440 Hz, or in other words, a pitch that cycles 440 times in a single second. Without diving into all the university-level calculus in a digital signal processing class, the graphs of these waveforms across the dimension of time can be transformed into frequency spectrum representations using a fast Fourier transform, where sounds are now seen across the dimension of frequency. As a quick side note, these spectrums are what music producers work with on a regular basis for applying processes like EQ and compression to get their desired mix of sounds in an audio track. So now, as for actually hearing a filter on some music, the best real-life example is when approaching a house or a club that has very loud music on. Even with the doors closed, usually we can hear lower frequencies, like the bass and drums. This is because objects like walls and doors act as low-pass filters, filtering out high frequencies. Likewise, high-pass filters filter out low frequencies. The low-pass and high-pass are the two most common forms of filters. Resonance. Resonance on a filter applied to a synthesizer's sound emphasizes the harmonics at a filter's cutoff frequency. The concept of resonance in physics is when something vibrates at a specific frequency matching one of the natural frequencies of an environment or system. Now that you know what a frequency spectrum looks like and what a given pitch will look like on that spectrum, let's dive a little deeper into harmonics. Every sound that exists as a periodic waveform in the universe has additional frequencies, also known as overtones, above what is called the fundamental frequency. The fundamental for an A440 mentioned previously is simply 440 Hz. But its overtones appearing above it will be dependent on the waveform involved. The waveform and its upper harmonics will vary by the real-life instrument that is being used. And of course, for a synthesizer, it will vary in the specific waveforms produced by its oscillator section. We can get some very interesting results by filtering certain sounds with different types of filters and applying different levels of resonance. UFO. LFO stands for Low Frequency Oscillator, which produces a waveform that has a frequency usually somewhere between 0.1 Hz and 20 Hz. This range is completely inaudible to the typical human ear, which can hear sounds from 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz. But your chosen waveform from the oscillator section can be fed into an LFO and thereby become modulated. The word modulation originally came from classical music, where composers would traditionally move to different keys within their pieces of music. The key of any piece of music would typically denote their tonal center. And this has been the basis for the composition of almost 1,000 years of music up until the last century, when composers decided to search for new compositional techniques. With the discoveries of and advancements in telecommunications and electronics from the late 1800s onwards, the term modulation evolved to describe the manipulation of electrical signals, especially for encoding them via amplitude and frequency modulation to be sent over long distances for what we know as AM and FM radio, as one example. And now, modulation for synthesizer waveforms borrows heavily from this new meaning, along with its original musical heritage remaining intact, since synths are essentially electronic musical instruments. So, the LFO is usually the special component in a synth that helps a user shape some really wild and creative sounds. LFO waveforms can be tweaked in speed, depth, waveform, and be assigned to various destinations to modulate a particular parameter of its input. Let's modulate the amplitude, filter cutoff, and pitch of this square wave using the depth and speed controls of the LFO on board this synth. First, the amplitude. Now, the filter cutoff. And finally, the pitch. One last thing to note here is that some synths may even have multiple LFOs to allow for further modulation of sound. Effects. Last in this video, onboard effects are often added to hardware to give synthesizer outputs an added dimension. The most typical examples of effects are delay to create an echo trail for a sound, and reverb to add spaciousness to a sound as if the sound waves were bouncing off the walls of a room or hall. Thank you. This concludes part two of this episode. Be sure to like and subscribe to be notified when the third part is ready. Thanks for watching.